Toledo, Oregon. Is it a hidden gem or maybe not quite worth it? Well, in this video, we're going to talk all about Toledo, Oregon, what it's like to live there. Stay tuned to learn more. Hey, what's up everybody? This is Paul Clem with the Home Team Brokers coming to you from the Oregon coast. And if this is your first time to the channel living on the Oregon coast, make sure to hit the subscribe button and tap the little bell to get notified every time we drop a new video. We talk to people every day who are relocating to the Oregon coast, buying a second home, vacation home, relocating full time, you name it. And we love to help with that process. So if that's you, give us a call, send us a text, shoot us an email, or click the link down below in the description of the video and schedule a Zoom call with us. Either way, we would love to help with your move to the Oregon coast. All right, so probably one of the more common things that we hear from people, and I know we've talked a lot about this, is people want to be by the ocean, people want to be by water, whether a river or lake, but in particular the ocean, have beach access when they're moving to the Oregon coast. A lot of people, though, are looking for more seclusion, places where they can get bigger lots, more land, you know, maybe be in the trees a little bit more, as opposed to being near the ocean. Some people are concerned about being at a lower elevation, for example. Some people don't want the hustle and bustle and the fuss of a tourist town. Some people really want to be tucked away, but again, still want to be near the beach, maybe 10, 15, 20 minute drive, for example. So there are some towns that meet that criteria, but really not too many. In this video, we're going to talk about Toledo, Oregon, because this is a place that is so close to the Oregon coast that we do get asked about it a lot. And, you know, on one hand, it is a coastal town. On the other hand, you could be in Toledo and feel like you're 100 miles away from the ocean. So Toledo is a relatively small town. You're talking about 3,500 people, which is smaller than the largest towns on the Oregon coast, but still a lot bigger than some of these smaller Oregon coast towns and villages that a lot of people do typically consider. So Toledo itself is just 7 miles east of Newport. Newport is right smack in the middle of the Oregon coast in Lincoln County, one of the most popular areas on the coast for people to move to, definitely a big tourism spot, definitely an area that is a little bit busier, has more amenities. If you're looking at Lincoln County as a whole, in particular, Newport and Lincoln City, we also have towns like Waldport and Yahats, some really popular areas that, again, draw in a lot of interest, draw in a lot of people. Toledo itself is in Lincoln County, so again, you're just 7 miles east of Newport. So if you live in Toledo, you're really going to be going into Newport for a number of things that you would need day to day as far as shopping, entertainment, activities, and of course to see the ocean. But from Newport, you know, you have Depot Bay to the north and then Lincoln City in particular to the north, you know, about 15, 20 minutes away. So some really great towns, relatively large population center just to the north of where you are. And then to the south, you have areas like Waldport and Yahats. Really beautiful, really scenic, smaller towns, but still, again, a ton to offer in that immediate area. So if we're looking at Toledo and that dynamic, being a little bit further removed from the coast, but still being 15 minutes, maybe even 10 minutes away, depending on where you're going and exactly where you're coming from, the access is definitely there. And there's not going to be a ton of towns up and down the Oregon coast or within this, you know, 5, 10, 15 mile stretch to the east where you're going to get the same type of access. There are certainly smaller towns along some of the highways that connect the coast with Western Oregon, with the rest of Western Oregon, you know, being in particular the Willamette Valley. So you have like Highway 26 Highway 6, you have 18, you have Highway 20, and down the line. And along these highways, you're really not going to see much as far as towns go, especially, again, within like 10 miles of the coast. Now, there are some areas that are more inland on the Oregon coast that you don't really feel like you are at the ocean. Like Tillamook, for example, comes to mind. But Tillamook is this big open valley where you have like four or five rivers coming into the Tillamook Bay. It's really beautiful, but it's right on Highway 101. And you have this huge body of water, you know, that you can see. And then depending on where you're at in the Tillamook or Bay City area, you know, you can see the bay, you can see that it goes out to the ocean. So, you know, you do kind of know that you're at the beach and that you're at the ocean. Whereas in Toledo, it feels to me, honestly, it feels more like a holler or a hollow, like in West Virginia or in North Carolina. And so I think aesthetically and just kind of driving through Toledo, driving around the town, to me, that's, you know, that it reminds me more of a place like that, like in Appalachia, than it does some parts of Oregon necessarily, because, you know, you're in this narrow valley right on the Yaquina River. And this is the Yaquina River that goes into the Yaquina Bay, which is where Newport is. And you have these, you know, pretty steep elevation changes coming from town. So again, it's this narrow valley. I mean, Main Street itself, and really most of the town itself, is just on this hill. But, you know, Main Street, you know, starts down at more or less the river level, and then you climb up, you know, pretty significant elevation just within the matter of like, you know, five or six blocks. It's a very different aesthetic. Again, it's a very different environment than a lot of areas that you can get on the Oregon coast. It's also going to be a lot more laid back, not just because this is a much smaller town than a lot of areas on the Oregon coast, but you're not going to get the same type of tourism. In fact, you're probably not going to get any tourism aside from, you know, people passing through, people coming, you know, from the east going toward Newport, or people coming from Newport going back home, or going back toward like Corvallis, for example. That is something I should mention too, is that along Highway 20, if you're going east back toward the Willamette Valley and back toward I-5, you can get from Toledo to Corvallis in just under an hour. I think it's about 45 miles. And Corvallis, Oregon, is where Oregon State University is. This is a town of about 60, 70,000 people. So you have the university, but you have also a great, you know, relatively large community, in particular when it compares to an area like Toledo. And then, like I mentioned, if you go west, you're really just about 10 minutes to Newport, 10, 12 minutes, again, depending on where in Toledo you're coming from, but it's 7 miles on the highway. So very easy access, very convenient in either direction to, again, a much larger place in Corvallis, and also still a much larger place, 3-4 times the size of Toledo, in Newport. A lot of people move to Toledo from the coast because it has a warmer microclimate and you're not going to get inundated with the wind quite as much as you do on the coast. So, you know, there's that marine layer of air. It's going to be colder. It's going to be probably wetter on average. You're going to get high winds, windier conditions on the coast. And that's true up and down the Oregon coast from Astoria down to Brookings. Again, you just get a little bit inland. We've talked a lot about this. You don't even have to go 7 miles inland in a lot of areas where, like, again, in Florence, for example, you have these coastal lakes and you can be over on the east side of the highway on some of these lakes. You know, it can be a lot warmer, feel a lot different in terms of the climate and the conditions than just on the west side of the highway toward the beach. So you're definitely going to get that dynamic in Toledo, being so close, getting to enjoy the access and proximity to the ocean, to the beach, but not having to deal with some of the conditions, which, you know, can be brutal depending on your tolerance for, you know, cold and rain and wind, but also for your home as far as the ongoing maintenance that is required. The closer you are to the beach, the more your house can get battered by these high winds and salty air. So what is it like living in Toledo? I've never lived there. You know, we've helped a ton of people relocate to the Oregon coast, in particular in Lincoln County, in this Newport, Lincoln City area. And so again, Toledo is right there and it's a place that we get asked about a lot. I know, you know, for sure that you're not going to have the same type of busyness. It's going to be a lot more laid back because you're not going to get the same type of tourism that the coast gets. The town itself is only about 2.5 square miles. So it's not very big. As far as a geographical footprint, it's not very big. You know, outside of that 2.5 mile, square mile footprint, it's going to be just all timber, very wooded, heavily wooded forest. And really, that's what you're going to get in the immediate area. So, you know, there's going to be old logging trails and things like that. There's going to be ways to kind of get out and explore nature in your immediate area, of course. And then also, you know, like we've talked about, and as you know, you have the beach and the ocean just to the west. Toledo itself is probably a little bit of a company town. You have the Georgia Pacific Paper Mill in town, which I believe Georgia Pacific purchased about 70 years ago. Toledo definitely was kind of a turn of the century timber boomtown, like a lot of Oregon, like in particular a lot of Western Oregon and coastal towns, where I think there was something like 70 mills operating in the immediate area or in the county. I read something like that, where now there's just a handful. So the timber industry in Oregon has been decimated over the last century for a number of reasons, but there is, again, a paper mill that is operating in Toledo that is operated or owned and operated now by Georgia Pacific since I believe 1953. That is one thing too I should mention that hasn't necessarily been on my radar as much when people are asking about Toledo, but a paper mill, you know, a lot of people associate a paper mill with kind of a foul odor in the air that it can emit. I've been to Toledo, you know, a ton of times over the years. I went to school in Corvallis, that's where I went to Oregon State. So headed out that way a ton to go to the beach, or there's a lake in the area that they stock trout, you can go fishing. So I've stopped in Toledo for food a ton, and then over the years helping people buy homes around there too. I've never noticed it, I've never smelled it myself. From what I've read online, from what I've heard from people, is it kind of depends on where your house sits. And if you're downwind or not, depending on where the wind is coming from, if there's a breeze, for example. So I think if you're right in the immediate area, you might have an issue. That is something to consider when you're looking at homes in Toledo. Okay, where's the paper mill? You know, where's this house I'm interested in? And just kind of make sure if that's something that could bother you, that you are far enough away to where it's not going to necessarily be an issue for you. I don't think there's necessarily going to be a ton to do in Toledo itself in the immediate area. There are some local shops and some restaurants on Main Street in town. You also have Mugley's, which is the bowling alley, kind of family fun center, arcade type area. So that is cool, you know, to have those things accessible in town. You can get into the, you know, downtown, walk around. You can walk along the river. Very beautiful, obviously. But I think for most of what you're going to do, kind of day to day, as far as activities, you know, needs like shopping, you're going to be going into Newport probably, maybe into Corvallis a little bit here and there as well. But again, you can get there in under an hour, so it's really not too far. That highway too, Highway 20, you know, there's again a lot of these highways that connect I-5, you know, with the coast, with 101. Some are going to be a lot windier than others. Some are going to be a lot harder to drive and less convenient than others. And Highway 20 for sure is definitely one of the easier highways. You just kind of go straight up. It's a very beautiful drive. And then you come back down, little wind, you know, little twists here and there. But it is one of the easier drives. So if you're looking at driving from Toledo to Corvallis or over to I-5 to get up to Portland, or down to Eugene, for example, not only is it quick, it's, you know, it's a pretty straightforward, pretty smooth ride as well. So just something to know. All right, so, you know, the town itself, you know, we've talked a little bit about the dynamics and what it might be like living there. Again, this is a turn of the century boom town, timber town, so a lot of old historic homes, which is really cool, and I think something that a lot of people are attracted to. There's not a ton of new development, you know, over the last several decades. You know, you'll probably find some relatively newer homes here and there, but you do have a lot of like old Victorians, a lot of which have been restored, which is really cool, and I think some people might find as a little bit of a surprise when they're looking at homes in Toledo. There's definitely a very picturesque, small town, kind of all-American town feel that you get when you're in Toledo. So it is a very scenic, very beautiful area, very unique as far as the dynamic and how, you know, the makeup of the town, again, especially when you look at it in terms of proximity to the coast and other towns that you might be looking at. I believe in 2009, Toledo was a finalist for, you know, the All-American City Award, which I don't know exactly what publication or who gives that award out, but that is something that, you know, when you look into Toledo, they're definitely going to tout that for sure. And, you know, I think there is some significance there. And going through the town, going through Main Street, It's not a surprise, you know, that Toledo would be up for that type of award just because of the feel that you get in going through the area. Now, probably one of the biggest reasons we get asked about Toledo is it's definitely going to be more affordable as far as home prices than some towns in the immediate area and other towns up and down the Oregon coast. So Toledo itself, you're looking at a median list price right now of $425,000. If you look at Newport, you're going to get closer to $500,000. If you look at Lincoln City, you're going to get closer to $550,000, $575,000 as a median sale price or median list price. So there's definitely more affordability in this area. The housing stock is less for sure. So I think there's going to be less options. But people, I think, look on a map, they see the proximity that Toledo has, and then they start seeing the homes there, the home prices. It starts to seem like a pretty viable option. And again, there's not really a lot of towns up and down the Oregon coast that have the same proximity, have that same dynamic where you can get more for your money, where you can get quick and easy access to the beach, where you can get more privacy, more seclusion away from tourists. So Toledo really has kind of a perfect mix of a lot of things that a lot of people are looking for. And then you add in the affordability piece and it can become a pretty desirable option for you. I think ultimately it just comes down to what you're looking for, what type of dynamic you want to have in your day-to-day life. If you want more peace and quiet and more seclusion, Toledo's probably going to be a place that you could consider. If you want more kind of a bustling area with fresh, you know, new faces coming in and out, in this case in the form of tourism, like in a Newport, like in Lincoln City and so many other towns on the Oregon coast, well, you're not going to get that in Toledo. But at this stage, you know, if you're still watching and Toledo is an area that is interesting to you, you want to learn more about it, maybe talk about homes there, or maybe talk about some other areas that could be similar. Again, Toledo's a pretty unique place as far as what it offers, but whatever it may be, you got to give us a call, send us a text, shoot us an email, or click the link down below in the description of the video. Schedule a Zoom call with us. We can put together a game plan for you, talk about your timeline, your needs, your wants, your budget, all of that, and get you set off on the right track in your home search for the Oregon coast. If this video is helpful, make sure to hit the like button. That helps us out a lot. And if you want to get more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Click the little bell icon to get notified every time we drop a new video. Until next time, as always, we appreciate you watching. We'll talk to you later.